Hello, everyone. Ever wonder where to get these? These are Rarecrows. They're just like a scarecrow, but rarer, as the name would suggest. There are a total of 8 in the game, and I'm going to show you where to get each and every one, starting with this fine young lady right here. She's not much to talk to, but she's still better than marrying Alex. Before we get into that, let's just take a simple look at what a scarecrow actually does and how it's made. You can make a scarecrow as soon as you level up your farming skill, which requires basically farming anything at all. Go to your crafting menu, Scarecrow, 50 wood, 1 coal, 20 fiber. And what they do is prevent the crows from eating your crops. They occupy an area roughly this big, which is very big. It's basically 8 spaces in any direction. Covers a massive, massive area. You want to use these. It's really annoying when crows eat your profits. You deserve those profits, not the crows. And maybe one day they'll introduce a Pam Rarecrow that will keep everything away from your farm. Animals, birds, people, even yourself will stay far, far away because it's so overpowered. Anyways, back to the actual video. This scarecrow. As I said, this Rarecrow is the first you can get. You get her at the flower dance, which happens on the 24th of every spring, and it's your only opportunity to cross this bridge and go look at what's over here for once. It is no doubt a very exciting event where people pace around in the grass a lot. Also, there are lots of flowers here, and a dessert that likes to move by itself. That might actually be a slime. Anyways, the Rarecrow we're after, and this is likely going to be the first one you're going to get, is sold by Pierre, the Rarecrow. It costs 2500 gold. Now, this is a lot of gold to spend this early in the game. I would actually recommend not getting this until your second or even third year. You probably have the money by the second year, but depending on how you play your game, you're probably not going to want it the first year. I'd rather use that 2500 gold to make more money down the road, then by year 2, you can buy whatever you want, including Emily. Next is this little guy, who happens to look like a dwarf, which is fitting because we get him from a dwarf. The dwarf is found in the entrance of the mines. At first, he's blocked by a purple rock barrier. You can get an upgraded pickaxe to break that or use a bomb. Once you enter, you find him hiding in the corner. This is where he lives. It's a nice house. He sells you a variety of things, some of them quite expensive, some of them quite useful though. I'm quite a fan of the bombs myself. Here's the Rarecrow we're talking about, again, 2500 gold. By the time you get here, you probably have enough money. It's up to you whether or not you want to buy it. You can buy this one anytime, so there's no rush. Buy this one whenever you want. However, before you can even communicate with the dwarf, you need to find all 4 dwarf scrolls, which are found largely in the mines. So if you find them, donate them to the museum. Do not sell them or lose them. Some of them are pretty hard to get, and you need all 4 before you're going to be able to communicate with that little guy. Now, speaking of the museum, we can actually get 2 Rarecrows from donations here. You get your first one at 20 donations and your next one at 40. And by the way, these are some of the dwarf scrolls I was mentioning. There's 2 here and 1 up there. As you can see, I got them miles apart because I think I built all these from the top left to the bottom right. Whatever the case, they're hard to find. The Rarecrows you get from those donations are this little raccoon guy from 20 donations and this yellow, I don't know, voodoo head thing for 40 donations. You're going to be donating things to the museum as you go, so you just kind of get those naturally along the way. You need 40 donations to be able to go to the sewers anyway, so you'll get those. Just don't throw any artifacts away. Don't sell them. Donate them. You'll find doubles. Sell the next ones after that. Hey, look at that. My dog wants to be in a video. I'm not going to pet him, though. Next, let's go ahead and find ourselves the alien Rarecrow, which, as it turns out, is the only Rarecrow in the game that can wear hats. So if you have a spare hat around, put it on his head. He'll enjoy it. It'll keep the sun out of his eyes while he's busy working. Now, we find the alien Rarecrow all the way in the desert, then even further yet, into the casino. So this one's going to take you a while. You need to unlock the desert first and then unlock the casino, which is a quest chain in itself, which is probably going to take you over a year to do. I believe it's sold by someone. This guy? Nope, he's selling the Statue of Endless Fortune. There's a reason a shady guy is selling your statue for 1,000,000 gold, because it's not really worth it. I forgot that there's a stat thing inside the casino. File on mumps. Steps taken, 1,270,000. That sounds about right. Gifts given, 922. Days in Stardew Valley, 12,569. Dirt hoed, 48,000. Items crafted, 0. Items cooked, 0. Well, I understand the cooked, but crafted is definitely wrong. Trash recycled, 402. And the list goes on and on. How about that? Items shipped, 446,000. Almost 500,000 items shipped. Okay, I think it's the Redeemer up in the right where you get the Rarecrow. Yes, this would be it, all the way to the bottom, not quite, Rarecrow, 10,000 of the casino coins. Casino coins are bought in the casino, obviously, 100 coins for 1,000 gold. So you can simply pay 100,000 gold to get the 100 key coins, or you can gamble for them. It's up to you. By the time you get here, you probably get enough money to do such ridiculous things. It's up to you. While you're at it, buy a Statue of Endless Fortune. Why not? Waste all your money. I suspect the game developer did that on purpose, made the casino a huge waste of money, as if referring to real life stuff. No, unfortunately, we gotta move a few seasons ahead to get the next Rarecrows. I'm still in spring, so I gotta move this along, so this video takes a little bit longer than I wanted it to. That's alright. Next, we have the Snowman Rarecrow, which of course is sold in fall, where there's no snow at all. Now, to be fair, you can get it in winter. This is only available in fall or winter, and you get it from the Traveling Merchant. The Traveling Merchant shows up every Friday and Sunday, right down here. She's very handy, you want to check her frequently because she has all sorts of stuff that is hard to obtain otherwise. Like Fiddlehead Risotto, I've never even heard of that, but she has it. Now, there it is, actually here today too. What are the odds? 4,000 gold. This one is a little bit more expensive, but by the time you're into fall, it might be worth the money. Especially because you don't know when it's going to be back again. It might take you another 100 visits or 4 years before you even see it there, so buy it when you see it. Then laugh when you place him out of season in the sun where he will melt. I think I've got a little bit too much scarecrow overlap there, I can't even see through it. Next is this fine young model. Not actually sure what this is supposed to be, but you get it on the 16th of fall at the Stardew Valley Fair. This is an event that I very rarely frequent, but let's see what happens. Now what you find here is something that looks like this. We have all sorts of new people in town from faraway places. There's a child. I wish I could steal that candy, whatever he's holding. That would be amusing. So in order to get this particular Rarecrow, we need to visit the shop and exchange in your star tokens for prizes. I don't have any star tokens, but the Rarecrow costs 800. Now, a good way to gather some tokens is see this guy right here. You want to bet on green a lot because apparently it's almost always on green. I don't have any star tokens to wager, but it lands on green I think 90% of the time, so that is definitely a good way to make your money. And you want to be careful because at 50 gold a piece, they're expensive. We'll buy one of those. Okay, 100, whatever. Round and round the wheel goes. Everyone tells me it always lands on green, like 90-95% of the time, so it better. Yep, there we go, there's proof right there. I'm up to 200, now I could bet 200, win 400, do it one more time, easy. Also, you get a display here where you can display some of your finest products. I have 9 of the mayor's lucky shorts and he's really a fan of this. Marnie, okay. I am now one with Marnie. Okay, there we go. I think that was actually the mayor's job to get in Marnie, but we'll go ahead and start this and see how he likes his 9 purple shorts. He's really got to keep better track of those. Yes, mayor, I'm ready. You should really have some variety in your life. Did that not work? Oh, there he goes. He's going for it now. He's gonna love what he sees here. That's why Marnie was all over me. She could smell the mayor on me. Hey, I bet this lady charges by the hour. Good morning. Wow, that's the biggest cheese wheel I've ever seen. Very impressive. And it's not the cheese wheel she's looking at. I bet it win. Those are iridium quality purple shorts. You can't just get those anywhere. It's been judged. Return to the Mayor Lewis for the result. What has he got to say? You, was that some kind of sick prank? Those are very private. Well, then you shouldn't leave them all over the town. Here, take 750 star tokens and don't tell a soul. There's the easiest way to make money. Don't give the mayor his purple shorts back. Wait till the display. Put them there. Easy. 250. And I'm gonna leave those there. So there you have it. Just like that, I can afford this thing. 800. I even have money to spare. And last but not least, number 8 on our list, the witch. The witch Rarecrow. Not surprisingly, she is found at the Spirit's Eve Festival on the 27th of fall. I've just realized today is the 28th, so I missed the date by one day. Hopefully I have another fall that's pretty close to that so I can show you guys. Whoops. Here we are, playing whoever this is, the 27th of fall, Spirit's Eve Festival. Like I said, there's a Rarecrow there, I promise, you'll see. This one starts late in the day, so make sure you go after dark. I believe 10 PM is the cutoff. Once you're here, you'll find all this good stuff. Very spooky, spooky area. There's a maze to the north, you can go wander around it there if you like. If you're just after the Rarecrow, of course, Pierre's selling it. He's totally taking advantage of people, by the way, selling these seasonal one-of-a-kind items for stupid prices. 5,000 gold for a scarecrow? Once a year? Yeah, I'll buy one. Again, that one is fairly expensive for 5,000 gold, but by the time you're at the end of fall, probably worth buying. If you want to wait for your second year, you can do that too, no rush. Well, there you have it. Now you're rich in Rarecrow knowledge. You know where to get all 8 and how to get them. Again, they're just a glorified scarecrow, they don't actually do anything differently, they're just something different to look at. Because in order to fill your entire field with scarecrows, you need quite a few of them, and the regular one looks pretty boring, especially when you have to do it again and again and again. It's just this, too orange, too generic. These ones, much more exciting, these are the way to go. Then, once you get rich, you can buy multiples of these and have all sorts of variety on your farm along with all sorts of varieties of crops. Anyways, if you haven't seen my channel before, go ahead and check it out. Tons of other videos just like this in there. New videos out all the time. Trying to do multiple videos per day. It's kind of working. I'm getting there, trying to put out as much content as I can. New ideas, new games up all the time. Harvest Moon coming out in just a few short days, so hopefully that's going to be good. It'll be like Stardew Valley all over again. I'm excited. Plus a bunch of other new games I've got my eyes on. Going to try a bunch of random games too to see what works for everyone. So keep it up with the good suggestions, good ideas, good whatevers, blah, blah, blah. Hope you like this one. Thank you all for watching. I want my hat back.